first of all, the medal was particularly rewarding because it's not just for my work as a scientist, but for the impact that it has had on society, the benefit of society. We hope my work really started as a scientist and then worrying about environmental problems caused by human activities. We decided to ask a question about some chemicals that were just being released to the environment, and we realized that they could pose a serious global environmental problem. At the beginning, it was just a hypothesis, but the science was sound, and we were able to work with the scientific community and to really pin down the science to a very good degree. But what was perhaps a step further was not just to stop at the science itself, but to communicate this to society and then to try to do something about it. So we were fortunate also to be able to work with colleagues, even diplomats and so on, so that it all led to an international agreement. And so this problem has to do with affecting the ozone layer that protects all of us from harmful radiation from the sun. It's truly global because these chemicals that we were worried about, it doesn't matter which part of the planet they are emitted. But the good news about it is that it's one example where the entire planet, all the countries in the world practically got together and decided to solve the problem. And it was essentially done this way. These chemicals remain a long time in the environment, so the problem is not yet completely solved by itself, because we have to wait until most of what was emitted last century goes away. But it's essentially solved from the policy and practical point of view, because the chemicals we were worried about are no longer being manufactured as a consequence of these international agreements. So we are very optimistic that with this precedent, we know that people can work together across countries, across different boundaries. We have one worry that it's the only precedent we have. So hopefully it's good enough so that we know how to keep fighting for other problems, global, local, that have to do with affecting our environment in ways that have negative impacts for society. Perhaps the two lessons, one is that it is important to recognize this responsibility, that it's not just science itself. But the second lesson, together with that, is that we have to be very flexible and learn many issues, many disciplines beyond the science itself, which have to do with, again, policy, economics, and just practical issues. What does it take to change people's behavior, and what does it take to implement policies? But even within the field itself of addressing, say, a large environmental problem, you need different branches of science, but you also need to communicate, as I was mentioning, to economists, to lawyers. So you have to be very open to this communication. You have to know something about all these different branches, if you want, of knowledge. And yet, it's very important in your own specialty to be as good as you can be. And putting all this together is how you can get society to improve.